outside knee kick and head kick early on from Sergio Wilson. He will waste no time. He's going to try and catch Rodtang cold here. And there's Rodtang. A left hook and a straight right hand, followed by a front kick to the midsection.
You can definitely see that Sergio Wilson knows the atmosphere of the ONE Championship, but he also understands the rule set, so he's coming on a lot faster than normal.
Rodtang, renowned in Thailand for not taking a backward step, always coming forward. A jumping knee from Wilson, a counter left hand there from the tank, Rodtang.
Wilson landed a nice little uppercut then, but he got caught flying in with an uppercut. Beautifully done by Rodtang.
Let's see if Rodtang gets on the inside. Starts going to the liver, starts going to the solar plexus, starts going to the spleen of Wilson. Wilson goes to the inside leg. Front kick again from Rodtang. This one opening at a cracking pace. A Muay Thai match in the ONE Super Series. Outside leg kick from Wilson. Suriname has produced so many great kickboxers over the years, the likes of Tyrone Spong, Remy Bunjaski, Melvin Manoff, Ernesto Hoost, and here we have Sergio Wilson.
That battle between the Netherlands and Thailand continues here at ONE Super Series.
Looking for a dump there, maybe. Rodtang threads the left hand nicely. Rodtang outside thigh kick, then a front kick to the midsection, uppercut. Went higher than my cholesterol. Left hook, right hand there from Rodtang. A high right roundhouse. And just gets upended. 1 minute 25 remains. No feeling out process here in the opening round. They clinch up now. A chance for the knees. A chance for the elbow.
Stop.
And referee Onari breaks them.
Go.
I like how Rodtang utilizes that uppercut. It's a beautiful cutting uppercut, especially because Wilson's got a little bit of a height advantage on it. Beautifully throws that kick to the side, attacks the body.
Oh, what a dump! What a dump there from Rodtang. My word! The way he pivoted and wrenched Wilson to the canvas, and there's the tough thumping right hand. Here's the power from Rodtang. There's the left hand.
He's wobbled.
Wilson's a rubber leg. He goes down. It's good night, Irene! Rodtang!
He's not done! Wilson ain't done yet!
Well, I thought he knocked him out. The referee puts his hands on Wilson. Wilson's still here. This is amazing. Rodtang had scaled the cage. He thought he had it won. How is Wilson still standing? Rodtang comes forward again. There's the left hand. The tie tank. There's the left again. And Wilson's knees buckle. No knockdown there. Can Sergio survive the round? Here comes Rodtang again. Amazing scenes here in Jakarta. Rodtang absolutely unloading on Wilson.
Look at that. Catching the punch on the head. He goes to Wobble Street. Falls down, beautiful left hook. Look at this, no legs, legs won't stay under him. Equilibrium is gone.
They touch gloves and we're underway. And Wilson comes out aggressively. Two punch combination and a front kick. There's another front kick from the Dutchman. And here comes Rodtang. They want to go toe to toe now. Rodtang comes forward, thrusts out the jab. There's a right hand. Cutting side kicks from Rodtang. Chasing Wilson across the cage. Wilson throws a hook and a straight punch.
Wilson's still a bit wobbly. He doesn't have his legs completely under him. Beautiful push kick. Caught him coming in.
Through an elbow there, Rodtang. There's the left hook. Wilson's going to get off the cage. And Rodtang tries the elbow again.
Oh, man, these punches coming from Rodtang, they sound like a bag full of hammers. They are getting thrown with some serious speed.
But Sergio's still here. He's not going to go quietly into the night. He's not going to wave the white flag. And there's another excellence of execution. A beautifully timed teep to the midsection from Rodtang.
You can see, and what's caught him off balance is that Sergio is in mid-attack. As he's getting these push kicks down, it's thrown off his balance completely.
Rodtang with more kick than a chorus line. Here in the second round, there's a front kick from Wilson. Throws one off the left leg. And Rodtang comes forward again, turning back kick, looking for the liver, looking to impact that vagus nerve, and close down the body of the Thai.
But how tough is Sergio Wilson to stand there toe-to-toe with Rodtang?
Wilson went for the uppercut elbow, good evasion, he leaned back like Fat Joe. A front kick to the midsection, a front side kick to the midsection from Rodtang. This one is crazy. This one is awesome. It's one Super Series Muay Thai.
Now look at Rodtang stalking down Wilson.
Stalking. He's trying to roll through him like a tank, always coming forward. There's no backing up on Rodtang.
Look at him, nowhere. Just consistently moving forward. That's what's different about the cage, Michael. There's no corner to back your opponent into. It's a circle. You can continually run around, and that's what's giving Sergio Wilson a little bit of time in this one.
Amazing scene here in Jakarta for this Muay Thai match. Rodtang with the kicks again off the lead leg. Sergio spinning back fist and just upends himself. 40 seconds remaining, second round of three.
I swear, Rodtang just winked at you, Michael.
They clinch up dead center of the cage. Rodtang breaks off, a chance for the elbows. He comes forward now. Sergio uppercut elbow, and Rodtang chases him. There's an elbow from the Thai. There's an elbow from the Surinamese, and Rodtang just dumps him to the canvas. 15 seconds on the clock. This has been an absolute rip snorter. Wow. Rodtang again with the power laid in left hand. There's the hook, smack bang. How is Wilson standing? A spinning back elbow and a counter elbow from Wilson. A right hand to the kisser. Rodtang with a roundhouse kick. Looks for the clinch and there's the end of the round. This is something sensational.
We are seeing just what all the hype is about with Rodtang. Look at that beautifully timed push kick. Right as Sergio Wilson is about to even attempt to think about attacking him, he gets pushed back onto his butt. There's a nice little elbow though, landed by Sergio Wilson. He's gotta be behind on every single judge's scorecard.
Third and final round, one Super Series Muay Thai match. A high right roundhouse kick there from Sergio Wilson. Backs him up with the left hand out of southpaw stance. There's a wild hooking right from Wilson. He's opened up like a house on fire. Overhand elbow from Rodtang.
He's marching forward. There's no fear in his eyes. He's continually pushing forward, challenging Rodtang to throw down with him.
Have you ever seen a walk forward style like Rodtang is showing us tonight? He doesn't take a backward step. He doesn't know how to go in reverse.
Man, you can just see the swagger just oozing out of Rodtang. Just the confidence and belief in himself.
Straight right hand, then a short right elbow. Smack bang on the kisser. Gives the beard a shave of Sergio Wilson. Wilson now at the knees, and Rodtang just ragdolls him and dumps him to the canvas.
Look at him just staring him down, begging him to get up so he can take more of this beating.
Sergio sticks out a stiff jab. That was nicely done. Rodtang goes for the headache maker. There's the uppercut elbow. A wild hook again from Rodtang. He's had more hooks than a Pirates convention. He comes forward again. Overhand right there from Sergio Wilson. Rides the head kick, covers up with a forearm. Rodtang catching right hand, but only a slip, says referee Onari. No count on Wilson. Picks himself back up. 1 minute 30 remains.
Wilson's continually trying to push forward, but look at this push kick. The timing is beautiful on it. Every single time Wilson enters that range, boom, the push kick's right there.
Again. Beautifully done from Rodtang. Keeps Wilson at bay. What has Sergio Wilson got left in his bag of tricks? This cerebral Muay Thai athlete from the Netherlands. And Rodtang comes forward. Sergio thrust out the left hand. They tango back against the cage. No knees thrown, and referee breaks them. Under a minute remaining now. Right hand from Rodtang. They clinch up another dump from the Thai. That is Muay Thai 101. And once again, Wilson's got to pick himself up off the floor.
Go!
Let's see if Rodtang goes back to the liver. Dips the right hand to the bread basket. Forces Wilson back against the cage. And Wilson comes forward. What guts, what tenacity here from the multi-world champion, Sergio Wilson. How many shots to the body has he taken from those kicks? There's one to the liver. There's one to the solar plexus. Sergio Wilson looks spent here. The final 15 seconds of what has been amazing. He snapped it. He snapped it to the side of the head. It's a second knockdown from Rodtang.
Six, seven.
That left hand has been superb.
You said what makes Rodtang so tough, what makes him so hard to deal with, you said it was his body shots. And that is what is breaking Sergio Wilson. Look at these push kicks continually going after the body over and over again. And Sergio Wilson just looks dejected.
Rodtang is a Muay Thai monster.
beautifully done. He faked the push kick, but still landed it on the second attempt. That was picture perfect. And he was sliding in with attacks over and over again. The push kicks were beautifully done in the third round. But what they were doing is they were setting up so many mother attacks. He was utilizing beautiful push kicks to punch combinations. And then he goes after the body. Look at that. Body, head, head, kick to the body.
By unanimous decision from the blue corner, Rodtang, Jitmuangnon.
Forward, Josh Tonner gets out of the way. Goes in early, throws a knee on the inside. Elbows and knees come into play here. Knees from both these men. Uppercut elbow from Petchdam. Crossing elbow from Tonner. Tonner got to watch his jaw here. There's an elbow again from Petchdam. Good work in the clinch from both of these men. Now referee Onari breaks it. Solid start to this contest.
See, Tona's listening to the advice of Michael Cervello as he's starting to inch forward to close that distance. He doesn't want to stay at kicking range with Petchdam, so he's got to get in nice and tight, let those hands go.
Ooh, cracking roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Petchdam. Goes for the inside leg. Tona continues to edge forward. Very high guard on the Australian. Nice left hook backs up Petchdam. Thought about the overhand right. Tonner defends the roundhouse kick. Can he counter? Yes, he can. Good combination from the Australian. Petchdam's left roundhouse kick is phenomenal. The power, you can feel it reverberate around this massive arena. Tonner got the right hand cocked and ready. There's a reason they call him a time bomb. Can the time bomb explode in the first round?
He's looking to do that, but that whole left side, the left punch and that left kick is really keeping Tona at bay.
Tona covering up well against the left roundhouse, fires out a straight right cross, drifts back to center cage, takes an inside fire, hit that one, just grazed the top of the head. Lightning fast and powerful. You see the left round kick again there from Petchdam. Tona, forearms. Guarding the body, guarding the head. Front kick there from Petchdam. Tonner waiting for an opportunity. Petchdam not allowing him to get on the inside. Tonner tries to thread the hook. Petchdam circles into Tonner's power side. Tonner hooks wildly off the backhand, catches the kick, goes for a sweep, executes it. They tie up now. Knee guard there from Tonner. Knee from Tonner to the rib cage. Knee from Petchdam. They tango back against the cage fence now.
Stop!
And referee Onari breaks them. 15 seconds to go in the opening round. It's been a ripper, Mitch.
I'd like to see Tonner start moving to the left and start timing that left kick. And as that left kick comes, if he can step off to the left of his own and let go of that big right hand.
Final seconds. Is there one big power salvo left for either man? It's a roundhouse kick from Petchdam. Double, triple, and Tonner. Oh, right blow there from Petchdam after the bell.
That action was constant. Look at that. There's that right hand jab from Petchdam.
Inside leg kick from Tonner. Didn't see many kicks from the Aussie in the first. Jamie McEwig, his coach in the corner, giving him plenty of instructions between rounds. Nice thread through there from Tonner. Takes a kick to the groin, and referee Onari will call time. So will be a recovery period here for Josh Tonner. Up to 3 minutes allowed for recovery and medical examination for the Australian. Mitch, you've been exposed to some fabulous Muay Thai striking in the brilliant One Super Series. These left kicks, though, of Petchdam are on another planet.
Yeah, man, when you get these southpaw athletes that have been throwing that kick for most of their lives, they just get so precise at it. Look at the way he changes. You can't really tell where he's going with it. He has a nice little cock to his hip.
And look at Tonner coming forward, trying to barrage on the inside. There's a big right hand and a left hook from Tonner. Sticky left there. Oh, Tonner catches him with the right. and again, the tenacity. He backs him up with the right cross. Josh Tonner, house on fire here in the second round. And Petchdam with the knees. Tonner showing no respect to the Thai superstar. That's the nuggety crease. Oh, the roundhouse kick for Petchdam! The roundhouse kick for Petchdam! Tonner's down! He said he'd knock him out in the second. And he's done just that.
Check this out. Cocked. Bold. Oh, look at that. That caught him with the knee and it hits him. Look at this. Let me take a look at it at a different angle. Yeah, it's right there. The knee caught him.
Outside leg kicking a high kick early on from Carly. How will the 8-week camp be for Rodtang Jitmuangnon? 8 weeks between contests. Good evasion there from Rodtang. Early quick start here from Khaled, stringing together some combinations with the hands and the legs, Mitch.
Khaled's utilizing those push kicks very well. He's connected on multiple push kicks. He's finding range with his strikes. He can't stand in front of Rodtang, though. He's got a... Oh, there it goes! A high kick from Rodtang! He's up on the legs! Mighty Khaled doing the chicken dance in center cage! And Rodtang puts a standing count on the Tunisian. Rodtang's unloaded! It's not even a minute down. Rodtang comes forward. The human tank, the wrecking ball. He's lining up the right. There's the left roundhouse kick. Rodtang fires the right hand down the tube. And Buddy Cullen ties him up. They tango back against the cage. A chance for the knees. And referee O'Leary breaks them. Rodtang has staggered the Tunisian kickboxing champion once already. Thought about the right-handed Cullen. Ties him up. Nice snake here, the hands around the back of the head, and a dump there from the two-time world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon. Overhand right from Carlin, looping left hand. Rodtang dumped him again like yesterday's garbage. And look at Rodtang say, come on, bring it! What have you got? Here comes Rodtang!
Again, screaming
look
at him.
This monster! Look at this battle tank!
It's got to move. You can see the experience advantage. Khaled has 41 total matches. Rodtang has 41 losses in his 300-match career.
Catches the kicking leg, Rodtang. Continually on the front foot here. Catches it again. And Khaled gets twisted and discombobulated. 40 seconds remains, first round. It's Rodtang's round. Front kick from the tie for the two-time world champion. Gloves up high on Rodtang. He doesn't want anything unexpected coming to the jaw from the swinging punches of Buddy Khaled.
4 ounce gloves, he has that opportunity. One touch on the chin, and that's it. It would connect there off the kick.
The roundhouse kick off the left there from Rodtang. The oohs, the ahs, the gnashing of teeth. This electrified crowd here in Manila. And Rodtang comes forward. A downward elbow from Khaled. Snaps the jab, there's a Tunisian. Rodtang misses with a roundhouse kick. A high check from the tie. Toe to toe now. Spinning back fist. Rodtang picks him off at the bell. What a round. Put on the book for Rodtang. The wrecking ball. The human tank.
We were talking about two sides of the coin. Which Rodtang would show up. And it was the first option. A hungry, just aggressive, just a beast of a man, Rodtang. Michael Cervello, I have a question. What's scarier in 4 ounce gloves? Jonathan Clyde Fairtex or Rodtang Jitmuangnon?
Buddy Khaled, high right roundhouse, high left roundhouse, good sticky right hand from the Tunisian.
He's got to move, he's got to keep that volume high. He can't stand there and let Rodtang tee off on him. He's got to keep pushing, circle away from the power side. Go the other way, Buddy Khaled, don't circle to the right.
Rodtang just coming forward without Relive, gets out of the way, leans back like Fat Joe. And Rodtang smiles at him, shakes his head, says he's got to do better than that fella.
Stop!
On a dump there! Khaled, that'll give Khaled some confidence.
His double leg takedown, wrong rule set there for Buddy Khaled.
Rodtang edges forward, front kick to the guts, front kick there from Khaled, evades the left hook, and Rodtang straight back on top of him, hunting after him. High kick from Khaled, Rodtang hooks the arm, spins him around. Nice little pirouette there from the two-time world champ.
Buddy Khalid's finding a little bit more success, at least in that first minute. He's got to keep the volume high. He has to keep Rodtang thinking and not allow that aggression to set in.
Rodtang cracks away to the humerus bone, but there was nothing funny about it. Right hand there from Buddy Khalid. Goes the liver, goes the head. Both punches miss. Spinning back elbow, and Rodtang blocks it. Says, come on! What have you got? Show me your guts and intestinal fortitude! Rodtang fires with a right hand dragon, and they both score the count.
Yeah, again, long moveset. Takedowns are not allowed in this one. You've got to keep this on the feet. But Buddy Khalid's got to keep moving. He can't settle in, or he can't get sucked into this game that Rodtang's trying to play. He needs to keep running, circle to the right, and get away from that power side of Rodtang.
Rodtang's telling him, don't back up. He wants to fight him toe-to-toe. He wants to fight him in a phone booth. A jumping roundhouse kick from Rodtang, and he throws him to the canvas. He dumps him to the canvas. Rodtang is an animal. He is an absolute beast. Caution there from referee Onari Mitch.
Onari did not like the takedowns that were being attempted by Fadi Khalid. He's got to move. He can't stand there. This is a better round for him. He has to keep active. He has to keep pushing forward. He can't allow Rodtang to tee off on him like this.
Fadi Khalid had a good idea then. Catch the kicking leg. Throw a downward elbow. Just didn't have the time and the distance. There's the downward elbow attempt again. Looking for the collarbone. And Rodtang upends it. Very smart for the 21-year-old. Buddy Khalid ties him up. Rodtang throws a knee. There's another one to the upper left rib cage. The tender rotation of Buddy Khalid. And Rodtang shuts him off.
Those knees were nice. He was able to lift up the inside the clinch. He elevates the right side. He elevates that right side and throws a big knee there to the body of Rodtang. That was a good idea.
This is one super series. A Muay Thai clash in four rounds gloves inside a cage. Between a two-time world champion, Rodtang, a six-time national champion in Fadi Khalid.
This is a much better round for Fadi Khalid. That round was definitely much more evenly matched. There, look at that. Fadi Khalid catches the push kick. Cradle switches the grip. Look at this. He keeps the foot, has it scooped nice and heavy right there.
Set, they touch gloves, and here we go. I'd
like to see more of that same round from Fadi Khalid. What he did in the second, he needs to do more of it here in the third. Start moving, do not stand in front of Rodtang.
Rodtang with the inside leg kick, almost buckled the knee of Fadi Khalid. Khalid with the right hand, can't cross, so to the hook of Rodtang. On the front foot again, the 21-year-old two-time world champion.
See, this time, look, this time he's circling to his right, away from the power side of Rodtang. So Rodtang's having to overextend on the right side. He's not able to put the same power in his shots.
Nice lead elbow there from Fadi Khalid.
Keep in mind the rule set. You can't clinch, you can clinch, but you can't take down off the clinch. And that's what Fadi Khalid was doing. It's buying him a little bit of time, and it's slowing down the tank, but you know, you can't do that. He's issued a yellow card. It's going to cost him 10% of his purse. It doesn't cost him a point, though, just money.
Front kick there from Rodtang. Jab from Fadi Khalid. It's preservation in the clinch for Khalid, I'm sure of it. Front kick to a nice long jab and a softball stance. Rodtang says, come on, let's do this. There's the handiwork from Rodtang. Here's the heavy artillery. The clinch now. The beautiful clinch from Rodtang. The vice-like grip of the tie. Beautiful knee almost folded in half.
Rodtang's competing like he's got a couple more rounds in here. I don't know if he realizes that he's only got 90 seconds left in this match. He's got to turn up the volume right now and put an end to this.
Crowd turning up the volume for Rodtang Jitmuangnon, a crowd favorite wherever he competes around the world. Spinning back elbow there from Fadi Khalid. Big kick from Rodtang. Khalid trying to find a way to break the overhand right. Nice kick to the liver from Rodtang. Wow. Close down that vagus nerve. Impact the entire body. Put it on delay. Leads under the hook for Khalid, sticks him with the left there, the right hand from Khalid. Good two-punch combination.
Go!
Dumped out from the tank, Rodtang. Under a minute remaining, Dragon.
Rodtang, he's letting Khalid off the hook. He kind of throws a bunch of combinations. He throws those 3-4 punch combinations, and then he goes in for the clinch rather than finish him on the feet. He's got good evasion. He's moving. But he can't lift
him. Looking into the crowd to see that left hook that missed. He was throwing that high back. Rodtang, full commitment behind it. Oh, there's a sticky right hand between the eyes of Rodtang with the leg kick. Rodtang hasn't taken a backward step for 3 rounds. Downward elbow. And he throws in the corner. Dumps in again.
Go!
Final seconds. Has one man got a big salvo left here? Khalid tries for it. Two-time world champion Rodtang comes forward once more.
Stop!
One sweep there by Buddy Khalid. And we go to the judges here in Manila.
By unanimous decision. From the blue corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
And he's going to try and get on the inside and work the overhand right. Petchdam in southpaw stance, so feeling our process so far, but that left leg is cocked and ready.
You can see his strategy. He's trying to inch forward. He's trying to apply that pressure. But, you know, he's kind of playing right into the strength of Petchdam. He's got to move.
Heading on the inside after riding a couple of high left roundhouse kicks from Petchdam. And referee Olivia Kels breaks them. But already you're seeing the speed and the power on that favorite left kick. Here comes Kenny C. Rockets in the right hand. Jab two there from Kenny. Falls short.
This is what Kenny has to do. He has to keep applying that pressure because that's 3 now. Big left kicks.
You can see the game plan at C trying to counter off the left roundhouse kicks.
I'd like to see him start moving a little bit to the outside to keep that foot constantly stepping out to the left because these are brutal.
Kenny gets on the inside again. Where's 3 left roundhouse kicks. Ties up Petchdam. Petchdam throws a knee. They tangle. And Olivia Kels breaks it. That left roundhouse kick of Petchdam is frightening. Kenny gets caught. He's out. This one's over.
A massive, look at this. Just, and then finished it off with the knee, and down he goes.
Rich, I was watching your facial expressions during that replay, and your eyebrows almost flew off your head. That is one of the greatest weapons in the combat sports world, isn't it? That left roundhouse.
I tell you what, if you didn't see it from the first kick that landed there, he was already out. And I think it was actually the knee that held him up from going down right there. Yeah. And then he's able to actually throw a third one. Interestingly enough, if you didn't pay attention, he did not throw, Petchdam did not throw any technique except for the leg kick.
They definitely appreciate his Bushido spirit, immediately attacking that leg inside and out.
4 ounce gloves, a Muay Thai contest. Rodtang the Tank, Jitmuangnon in the red and silver. Hakim Hamesh of France in the white and black. Goes to the inside thigh, just Rodtang. Good right hand there from Hakim Hamesh. Hamesh, a world Muay Thai champion multiple times, should not be underestimated. Has speed, has precision. We'll need to rely on those 2 things and the volume against Rodtang.
Surprised how Hakim Hamesh is not moving. He's standing right in front of Rodtang and letting Rodtang just hammer on that lead leg.
Let's see how long it takes for Rodtang to get on the inside and start to land the leather at the moment, kicking range from the tie. Hakim Hamesh drifts off to his right. There's the right hand, smack into the kisser, one to the liver, goes off the left from Rodtang. Uppercut elbow from Rodtang. Already the heavy artillery being launched in the opening round. Kicks to the midsection from the tank, Rodtang. Ooh, Hakim Hamesh stuck with that left hand, and a turning left hook there from the Frenchman. Two of the best Muay Thai countries of the world, well, the best Muay Thai country in the world, Thailand. And you talk about the Western world, well, in history, France is right up there with the Dutch. Maybe a little behind, but not far. We maybe talk about the best Western Muay Thai stylist of all time. There's a big argument to be made for a Frenchman named Danny Bill. Jab two there from Hakim Hamesh.
Interesting.
interesting strategy right now for coming from Rodtang. You can see that first minute was all about the leg kicks. He was just hammering that big leg of Hamesh inside and out. Now he's choosing to go to the body. You can see the welds starting to add up on that right side of Hakeem Hamesh's body. He's attacking with push kicks as well. I think he's trying to soften Hakeem Hamesh up, trying to get him to drop that arm and then start to go headhunting.
Entry counter there from Hakeem Hamesh. A lot of great French kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years. The likes, as I said, of Danny Bill, maybe the greatest. Jerome Labana, Dita Diafant, who was an 11-time world champion. Looping left hand there from Hakeem Hamesh. Looking to follow in the footsteps of the Muay Thai greats. We're talking Samar Payakaru again. Yeltsin Black, Fairtex, Sunshine, Etchabut Chuefe Group, Diesel Noy. Such a long list from the land of smiles. Referee Elias Delapsis right on top of the action here. Final seconds of the opening round. It's been entertaining, but really still a filling out process between these two champs.
Stop. Hakeem Hamesh was able to land a nice right hand to rock Rodtang. Rodtang ate it down and kept moving forward. Look at that.
Now we should see Rodtang pick up the intensity in those 4-ounce gloves. There is no room for error. Accidental groin strike there on Hamesh. Roundhouse kick, and again from Rodtang. Good jab from Hamesh, the jab to it, full extension from the Frenchman. Left hook to a right hook from Rodtang, the tank. Step through the Hamesh. Nice tuck there for Hakeem Hamesh.
Hakeem Hamesh is not giving an inch to Rodtang. He is standing right in front of Rodtang and trading shots with him. We've seen Hakeem Hamesh, a beautiful counter striker when he wants to. The beautiful sidestep that he performed on Ogasawara to knock him out in one of the final rounds was absolutely brilliant. But this time, he is going toe-to-toe with one of the best strikers in ONE Championship.
Some really good refereeing here from Elias Delapsis, allowing the clinch to go on. Both men staying busy. Uppercut trying to snake in that right arm there. Rodtang worked the clinch around the back of the neck. Can't get it on at the moment, though. Needed midsection, folds him in half. Elbow tried to come over the top. There's a step uppercut elbow from Rodtang off the lead arm. Crossing elbows from both men. Another crossing elbow from Hakeem Hamesh, uppercut from Rodtang. Good crossing elbow to the jaw from Rodtang. Just losing his footing there, Hakeem Hamesh. Rodtang has gone to the next level here in the second round. Good cover up, close body of Hamesh. Hamesh returns the favor. 1:05 remains, second round of three. Thailand versus France. Two traditional Muay Thai rivals. Two phenomenal Muay Thai countries.
Man, Rodtang is known as just a destroyer. He just comes forward and he runs through everybody. But he's also very technical. Watch him inside the clinch. The way that he parries arms, the way that he blocks biceps. He is controlling so many different aspects, especially at this close range. It's extremely impressive. Watch that clinch game. See how he controls the biceps like that to prevent Hamesh from grabbing his head.
Beautiful liver shot there from Rodtang. Hakeem trying to get inside the guard. Can't get through the forearms of Rodtang Jitmuangnon and dumps him to the canvas. Nicely done from Rodtang.
Beautifully done. The way that he kicked, Hamesh was coming forward. Rodtang sidesteps, swept out the support leg and put Hamesh face down.
Look how Rodtang wears these punches in the forearms, waits for a pause from Hakeem Hamesh and then pounds to the body.
Great.
Excellence in execution from Rodtang. Comes forward again to the tie, escapes the uppercut attempt, fires out a front kick, one more round to go.
Watch this brilliant work coming from Rodtang inside the clinch. Look at that control on that overhand side, unable for Hamesh to get inside. Soon as Hamesh tries to bring the hand up, Rodtang is able to come over the top and land that forearm to the chin.
Great sportsmanship and respect from both of these warriors.
Stop!
Really dumped there from Rodtang.
Again, beautifully sidestepped. Fell Hakeem Hamesh pushing forward, sweeps the head out.
Another dump from Rodtang.
Now, while those might not necessarily score for Rodtang, what it does is it mentally deflates Hamish. It means he's got to pick himself up off the canvas. Here comes Hamish with a powerful right hand now. Step through a knee for the Frenchman and a crossing elbow. And Rodtang responds, dunks him again. Continually Hamish having to pick himself up from these dumps of Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
It's deflating, it buries your ego. Look at that control, it just shows the dominance that the Iron Man has inside there. The way that he's able to sidestep, sweep, and then he uses his hand to parry the head down of Hamish to add even more force to the fall.
Clinch, chance for the knees. Late knee thrown there from Rodtang. Comes forward again, that high double forearms guard, throws the uppercut on the hook, uppercut from Hamish, crossing elbow, trying to open the cut on top of the head, glancing right hand from Hamish. Got to be careful not to drop that head too low, he'll open himself up for a rising knee with Rodtang. Referee Elias Dolapsis breaks him. 1 minute 35 remains, third and final round, a Muay Thai contest here in Tokyo, and another dart from Rodtang. I've lost count, Mitch.
Michael, you can see that Rodtang has adapted his guard very well to the small gloves. It's very hard for Hamish to land the hooks to the head. You can see him landing them, and the way that Rodtang is wearing those on his forearm is extremely professive. I'd like to see Hamish throw uppercuts. I'd like to see him how he's working the body. That works well too. Uppercuts to the body shots are going to be how he's going to get this round.
Jab two from Hamish, a little slow though now from the Frenchman. Glancing left from Rodtang, step up elbow from the Thai. Crossing elbow, went all out on that one. Rodtang certainly has some powerful salvos left here with 45 seconds on the clock. Hakim Hamish glances towards his corner. They are imploring him, but it's in French. I don't know what they're saying, but I think I get the general gist. It's come forward. You've got to throw hell for leather now. Uppercut from Hamish. Listens to his corner.
There's the uppercut. That's how he's going to find those holes in Rodtang's guard. He's got to land those uppercuts. Go to the body.
Nice elbow there from Rodtang to the orbital of Hakim Hamish. There's the uppercut from the Frenchman.
Rodtang is using those elbows beautifully. Every time he gets into range, every time he's able to control the positioning of the arms, he's able to sneak those elbows right over the top and connect.
Final seconds of a brilliant contest. And we go down to the judges. Look at the respect.
Look at that. He's able to slip the big left hook coming from Hamish, but then he's able to answer right back. Land shot, look at that, he just wears it on the chin, marches forward, shrugs the head up, but then watch the work of Rodtang inside that clinch. Look how he parries the arm down, gets him thinking about the other side, and then lands another big forearm.
By split decision from the red corner, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Kickboxing rules, the southpaw stance on Petchdam. Look out for the left roundhouse kick. So far, he's knocked out two opponents in one super series with that kick. Body shot there from Kudo. Nice combination work from Kudo. That's what he's going to do. Get on the inside, land the blows, get out of range of the left kick. Front kick there from Kudo. Goes downstairs. Got to do everything he can to watch the right side of his body. Cover up the head. Check the low kicks. It's all going to come off the left leg of Petchdam Petchyindee Academy. Slams that one away, just caught him on the elbow. Two-time Muay Thai world champion in the sky blue. Always a different hair color when he gets in the ring of the cage. Tonight it's yellow and red. Last time I believe it was green and white. There's the roundhouse kick again, and already you can see the reddened carcass of Kudo. Looks like it's been sunburnt. Body shot from Kudo. Short knee there from Petchdam. Under these kickboxing rules, no elbows are allowed. You are allowed to knee for a short time frame, but the knees must be continuous. Long-reaching jab there from Kudo. Needs to use his reach advantage. He's not moving it up though, Kudo. They're not standing flat. Petchdam letting him tee off like a golf course with that left roundhouse kick. Knees there from Kudo on the inside. Referee Olivia Jones breaks them halfway through the round, Mitch.
Yeah, but that's what Kudo does. He likes to get tight and he likes
himself in the perfect position for Petchdam just to get very comfortable throwing that left hammer of a kick.
It's all about timing for Petchdam. Sets the rhythm of the left, finds the chink in the arm of the minute hole. He drills those knees to the liver section of Kudo. Resets here, the two-time world's Muay Thai champion in the sky blue, the two-time world's kickboxing champion in the red, and a nice high forearm guard against the round kick there. Straight left lead from Petchdam Petchyindee Academy. Kudo, a three-punch combination, just not enough start behind the left hook. Now on the inside, knees from both men. Nice knee to the midsection, they tango back against the ropes, and Olivia Goss breaks up.
Like how Kudo's keeping that right hand just glued to his head, right there to the forearm. He is back a little bit more, maybe step in, counter that kick of Petchdam. Throw that straight right hand right down the middle.
There's the high kick, trying to put the shin around the back of the neck. Now Kudo ties him up, takes him back against the ropes. Couple of knees off the left there from Petchdam. 15 seconds on the clock. Jabs in from Petchdam. The high kick! Tries to pull the head down for the meet and greet. There's one to the midsection, tries to fold him in half like origami. Final seconds of the opening round.
That's what Petchdam does. He throws that kick, but that was a good little scoop deflection there from Kudo. But Kudo's getting caught inside the exchanges. So he's deflecting, but he's coming in. But that's when Petchdam's coming on a little stronger.
Petchdam of Thailand in the blue, Muay Thai world champion. They open up with the knees. You're already seeing the red knee on the right side of the body of Kudo, courtesy of the roundhouse kicks in the first round of Petchdam. Kudo is going to take Petchdam into the deepest water he's been in yet in one Super Series.
Sets it up with the left kick and then right down the middle with that left hand. Look at that. Maybe we have a new left highway.
Traditional respect before they engage. And the Iron Man unleashes with kicks to the inside of the leg, to the outside, and then a teak kick takes one in return. It's a battle of the feet at the moment. Exchanging, slapping kicks that will leave bruises for sure. And it's Sok T who's on the rough end of it. He goes upstairs, Rodtang. Gets pushed back.
Man, I need some slow motion replays on those kicks of Rodtang. Those are coming with some serious speed.
Real heat. 30 seconds. The hands come into play as well at the 40-second mark. Sok T just hoists up his shorts, seeking any protection he can get from these body blows that are coming in at pace. It's lightning quick, Mitch.
It is, and it's coming with some serious power as well. You hear it's a slap, but there's also a thud to the inside of that leg kick as well. Sok T can't allow Rodtang to back his back up against the fence right there. You can see him just slowly inching forward, throwing those leg kicks to just kind of pin Sok T there. Alexi, Sok T circle out.
It's not an exaggeration to say that these kicks are coming in so quickly. Sometimes you're not sure what you've seen. Nice left hand work. Goes body and head, Rodtang. Superb offensive work here, and he bashes himself in the chest and in the face. He's taken more punishment from himself than he has from his opponent in the last 10 seconds. Really up for this. And those legs of Sok T are taking some punishment. He just pushes his opponent back 4 or 5 feet, giving himself a little bit of respite. Doubles up on a jab that lands short. But at the moment, he's off the pace.
Sok T's kind of mesmerized at this point. He's got to do something to earn the respect of Rodtang.
These two hyper-experienced 21-year-olds.
Wow, what a... Fainted the jab and then came around to a beautiful left hook.
Sok T just showing us the potential threat there with a big overhand right that might possibly have brushed the nose of Rodtang. But at the moment, all of the really quite exquisite work is coming from the Thai. And it's relentless. There's no room to breathe. They keep coming in every couple of seconds. Jab, kick, he gives him a nod after receiving a left hook to the jaw. A nod of respect. Left, right, followed up by kicks. This is exhibition stuff from the Thai athlete.
Great kicks.
Left hand, and down goes Sokti, and I'm not convinced that he's getting up. He clearly hurt his leg. He's nodding, yes, I can continue, but it doesn't look feasible, Mitch, does it? Saved by the bell.
Wow, those leg kicks on Tang just getting aggressive here. Punching himself in the face, like you said. He took, he hit himself more times than Sokti's hit him.
That time he is like a man possessed.
Sokti's got to check some of these kicks.
Oh, left hand, right kick, deep kick. Sokti comes back with something, and that's what he has to do. He's got to send a message to his opponent. Meanwhile, right, left, that leg is in big trouble, isn't it?
He's just walking him down, putting his back up against the fence, and then just throwing some nasty combinations, and they're all ending with leg kicks.
You've got to admire Sokti's resilience here, and the resistance, but for how much longer? Superb left hook to the body, like Barry McGuigan of old in the 80s. Once again, left hand and right hand. Kicks to the body as well. Again, he goes downstairs with that wonderful left hook to the body.
Just ultra-aggressive. Rodtang marching forward. The tank is rolling through Bangkok.
That is a gorgeous left hook to the body. That leg, how much more can it stand? Again, he goes left hook to the body, right to the head, kicks to the left leg. Sokti stays on his feet. Directly above us here, circle side, in Bangkok at the Impact Arena. And Rodtang is thrilling these fans.
How tough is Sokti? He's still in it. He's not backing down, he's not going anywhere.
Left hook to the body, the tree has come down. He attacked that trunk and offering his condolences. That left leg of Sokti was taking huge punishment. You can see him hobbling around doing all he can, but that was the finishing blow. Inside and outside of Sokti's left leg, and then a barrage of punches. Left, right, left, right, left, right. Sokti's left leg is going to be sore tomorrow. It's pretty sore now. Oh, right hand was big. And it set Petchdam down for a moment. A little bit of confusion.
I don't know if he was trying to throw it as he was maybe throwing his hand. You could see him fake, and then, yeah, that's very clearly an elbow.
Yeah.
That is pretty clear. 30 match veteran as far as Muay Thai is concerned, multi-time world champion. Looks like he's being issued a yellow card.
That seems perfectly legitimate, doesn't it? Very, very early on in this contest. And that will be a bit of a worrying start for Mahudi.
Go!
Very apologetic, and that's good to see. Nobody believes that was premeditated, that's for sure. But the barrage continues, and now we're erupting. And Mahmoudi got his kick almost caught up in the circle wall there.
Mahmoudi's trying to get something back. He's immediately pressing Petchdam back, trying to throw big shots. Petchdam's trying to answer, but that range is so... Man, it's hard to deal with. Look at those kicks.
You get on the end of those long legs and you do get pushed back into the circle wall, just as Petchdam was there. And for all the personality that we saw coming into the circle a few moments ago, Mahmoudi is showing that it's about focus on the task at hand. He lost a bit of that focus in the first few seconds, but he seems to be recovering it now.
Huge left kick, pay close attention to it. Mahmoudi does not seem fazed by it. Standing right inside that kicking range, throwing huge shots.
He is a tall, tall, rangy man, and that is a big threat for Petchdam at the moment.
Yeah, he's a gigantic flyweight. 178 centimeters tall.
Oh, good left hand from Petchdam. That landed flush.
Anything that comes off of Petchdam's left side is seriously puts you at risk.
Left hand again, but he eats a left hand in exchange.
Nice catch and counter from Petchdam there.
Very well executed indeed. Spinning back kick to the rib cage. Heavy right hand Moody has, the Algerian. That long neck of his sticks it out, but low, high guard. They are putting everything into these kicks. Left hand was heavy from Petchdam. And Mahmoudi needs to take a step backwards. Back onto the breach though.
Mahmoudi hasn't thrown out any spinning attacks yet. He's been very conservative in his first round here. Just throwing big, heavy straight shots. There it is.
World Championship contest, 5 3-minute rounds, and we're into the final 20 seconds of the first.
See how patient Petchdam is. Very slow, methodical steps back before he fires off something from his left side.
Right hand from Mahmoudi was crisp, and it shook the face of his opponent. Final moments of this opening round.
Look at this shot from Mahmoudi. Steps in, comes over the top with a huge overhand right. If the angles at which Mahmoudi throws these things, he comes out from the very, he's always throwing you off of one foot. He can throw with big power just standing on one shot. There's Petchdam coming back with a left hand of his own. I know that most of these fans paid full price for their seats, but they are only using the edge of them because everybody is at the edge of their seat right now.
Right jabs from Petchdam, and they will be a little bit short unless he gets right inside those long arms of Mahmoudi.
You see Petnam's trying to counter-strike. He's trying to back up slowly, getting ready to load that left side as Mahmoudi lets go of a combination.
Just prior to that, there was a spinning back kick that, if it had landed, might well have finished the contest.
Nice straight left hand to the body there, landed by Petchdam.
Just looking up at these two athletes, the overriding feature is Mahmoudi's height. For a flyweight, he really does pack an awful lot into that frame. And he smiles at Petchdam. And they exchange brutal kicks.
Big left shots landed by Petchdam as Mahmoudi throws that right kick.
Oh, nice right hand from Mahmoudi. Counters very well and sends in combinations. Very solid right hand from Mahmoudi.
Mahmoudi's doing a good job of checking that left kick. He's blocking a lot of these shots thrown by Petchdam. But I like those combinations that he lets go. Petchdam landed a nice jab there on the exchange.
Petchdam really is taking these big punches well. Seems to have a very solid chin. Holding the leg and throwing the left hand, and it landed bang on the beard. That left hand just, sorry, the right hand grazed Petdam's face. Had it landed flush, that one could have made a difference too.
I like how he follows it up with the uppercut. So he throws the big right, and he comes right up underneath with that left uppercut.
Fearsome kick to the head from Petchdam. That left leg walking over time, fakes, and then throws.
You can just see the guard of Mahmoudi. He's done his homework. He knows that that left kick is coming, so he's got his right hand glued to the side of his head as he spins there.
That spinning back kick, Mitch, did connect. Didn't quite have the power that the one we saw a few moments ago looked to unleash. Good left hand from Petchdam, and he threw a nice combination there. Scoring punches. 42 seconds left of this second round.
I like that skip in. I like how he throws the right kick, and he throws that punch right after it. He's still off balance. He's got all his weight on one foot. Very tricky striker is Mahmoudi.
1.5 minute. Oh, holding and hitting. Beautifully executed by Petchdam. They exchange kicks high up there on the body. Rushing forward, throwing the right hand, and two more.
It's interesting with Petchdam, when he catches the push kick, you have to let go of the foot. You can't hold the foot and strike at the same time. You have to catch the foot, let it go, and then you can strike under kickboxing rules. So he has to be careful with that.
What Mahmoudi is throwing, Mitch, is fearsome stuff.
Look at that spinning attack. See that beautiful spinning wheel kick, and as soon as he lands, starts firing the punches. So it's not just one shot. He's not just throwing one fancy kick or punch. It's followed up with a few others. And these two are making the judge's job extremely difficult because these have been two very close rounds.
Perhaps McGruby doing the slicker work of the two, but I agree with you, very close. 10-point system is what these judges will use to find their winner.
Nice left hand landed by Petchyindee there.
And a nice right from McGruby, follows it up with another one. Doesn't seem once to have been bothered by the heavy artillery, and that was another solid right from Mahmoudi.
Those knees, and he exits with a beautiful left hook.
Surely these blows have to start telling soon, Mitch. That chopping left hand brought Petchyindee flush on the jaw.
Yeah, Petchyindee's wearing these shots extremely well. He's got an ironclad chin. Oh, that left beautiful hook there as he was stepping forward.
Booty does not throw much that misses.
His pinpoint accuracy, Steve. Look at that combination. Jumps into the skip knee, lands the right hand.
I think Booty is complaining about another elbow. Certainly complaining about something. The referee has noted it. All of Petchyindee's work mirrored by the fans here at the Impact Arena. With cheers of joy and support. But at the moment, their man is slightly behind, I fancy. Good two-handed work from Matt Moody.
And these guys, they know each other so well. They have done their homework. They are blocking a lot of these shots, but it's the second and third shot that you have to pay attention to. Watch, they'll throw the right kick or the left kick, but then it's the follow-up combination that lands.
Seems to have everything in his arsenal, Matt Moody. And an Algerian spinning back fist there as well. And it landed. Doesn't waste much, does he? Beautiful in a counter-attack there. These rounds are flying by. We are entering the final 40 seconds of round three. And Moody steps up the pace once more. I have to say, these Thai fans are appreciating the work that the Algerian's doing.
That's two good left hands landed by Petchyindee.
But another heavy right from Mahmoudi.
Look at those combinations landed by Mahmoudi.
What a contest this is.
I like the feints coming from Petchyindee as he closed the distance on the spin. Didn't connect though, but now he's starting to read what Mahmoudi's starting to do.
Lunges forward and lands a short right hand, and Petchyindee lands a super left. About accurately, unless you are judging about accurately. And we're not doing that. We're calling the shots.
The check is beautiful, though. He's able to time that left kick. You know that's coming. That's what the referee's warning about. It's the way that Petchyindee's catching it, and then he's striking, so he's not letting go of the kick. You have to release the kick once you catch it if you want to strike.
It's Mahmoudi who has the yellow card, remember? An incident that happened in the opening seconds.
And when the match is super close, beautiful hand combination thrown by Mahmoudi.
Wonderful stuff from both of these men. Petchyindee is relentless. He will not back off despite the quality that is being aimed at his head.
Man, Petchyindee is wearing these. Oh, beautiful back fist.
Right from Petchyindee was solid. Mahmoudi's head was thrown back. It lurched backwards. Good work from Mahmoudi to the chest.
Oh, nice timing there from Petchyindee to avoid the wheel kick and then land the body shot.
Beautifully done, wasn't it? The right jab there from that southpaw stance. Petchyindee's face starting to puff up a little bit around the eyes and nose. Still quite a long way to go here.
Man, Steve, he's been hit with some monster shots. These are little gloves. Yeah. He's barely showing any signs of damage. His skin must be made of leather.
What durable men these are, Petchyindee in particular, because he's eaten more than his fair share. And now Petchyindee complaining about the elbow again. Mahmoudi does have to watch that. And as you say, the yellow card could have some influence in the judges' decision. Good left hand from Petchdam, and he follows up with another. Mahmoudi backed up against the circle wall. Eats another good right hand from green-haired Petchdam, who keeps on going.
Oh, that hook. Oh, the Mahmoudi answers right back.
A superb right hand from Mahmoudi in reply. Petchdam can be forgiven for perhaps taking a breather and not going relentlessly all out. Just steps off a little bit, and I wonder if that will be a turning point, because had he continued, he might well have had Mahmoudi in a little bit of trouble. And look how much Petdam's face is swelling up. Left hand was big, and the crowd appreciated that, but Mahmoudi countered very well with the right.
Sky, Steve, great defense.
Oh!
Look at that check, beautiful check kick there from Mahmoudi.
Swinging. Oh my goodness! Comically mistimed, but it gives you an idea of Mahmoudi's ambition, doesn't it?
Where's the kitchen sink, Mahmoudi? Is that next?
My colleague Mitch Chilson is on his feet applauding these two, and rightly so. He's joined by just about everyone else in this wonderful arena.
Those hand combinations of Mahmoudi, that's where he is landing the most significant shots, is inside that exchange. He throws 3 to 4 beautiful clean shots, and two of them land in flush.
It's very possibly all about these final 3 minutes.
Oh, low blow.
Central.
In favor of your winner by a technical decision, and now the one flyweight kickboxing world champion, Petchdam Petchyindee.
One brought to you by Hobbs and Shaw. Champion from the UK, left of screen, the challenger from Thailand, right of screen. They exchange round kicks early. Look for the elbows, look for the front kicks. There's one from Haggerty. Look for the sheer brute power of Rodtang. Inside leg kick from the top. More than 140 martial arts world champions on the roster at one championship. You are seeing two of them in the ring at the moment. Got to wonder, can Rodtang maintain his composure? High check there. Jab two from Haggerty. That's the precision. That's the excellence of execution from the general.
Good work so far from Haggerty, especially with these kicks, man. And that's what he's doing. He's laying that bait. Now he landed a few push kicks, and now he's starting to bait the push kicks. And that's how he sets up those elbows. He slides in forward and throws those elbows off of that fake push kick.
The push kick of Haggerty, one of the best in the business. Pulls the toes back, extends the ball, the foot drives it into the midsection of the opponent. Roundhouse kick from Haggerty. There's the push kick, and it's set Rodtang back against the ropes. Again, the succulent technique of the 22-year-old world champion from the UK. Front kick again from Haggerty. Scoring points. We do have three judges ringside. Scoring on a 10-point must system. Give the winning boxer 10 points per round. The less dominant boxer gets 9 points. At the moment, with the front kicks, it's Haggerty doing the scoring.
Rodtang's having a hard time with the range of Haggerty. That lead push kick is causing a lot of problems for Rodtang. Rodtang's not used to just standing there taking these shots. He's usually the one pushing forward, throwing those shots.
He is landing every one of these front kicks. There's a downward elbow, hoping to crack the collarbone. When we spoke to Haggerty yesterday, we said, what were you most looking forward to about competing against Rodtang? He said, I can't wait to kick him. I can't wait to front kick him. And he's done plenty of that so far, with 45 seconds remaining in the first round, set for five.
It's all those, I like that little change, that little stance change that he does as he throws that right kick.
Haggerty's flyweight Muay Thai world title on the line. There's a front kick off the lead leg from the general. Nice 3-2 combination. Inside leg from Rodtang. The Iron Man. Both wearing the Project armbands. A little more flamboyant, those around the left bicep of Haggerty. The more super Project around both the biceps of Rodtang. All part of the tradition, the custom, the superstition of Muay Thai, a martial art dating back some 3,000 years. Front kick again, counters up his left side.
Look at that beautiful left high push kick, fakes it, and puts the rope save Rodtang from ending up on his butt there. Just that timing is just beautiful coming from Haggerty.
Where there's not much time for a feeling out process, not much time to wait and see what your opponent's got to offer. You've got to go hell for leather from the opening bell. But here we have five rounds. Front kicks again from Haggerty. Checks the inside leg kick. Rodtang, you feel, is just trying to get his timing off that front kick to work a counter. Maybe it'll be a big overhand right. Maybe it'll be a hooking punch. But that's what he's going to try and time off, the front kick of Haggerty. There you see it again. A catch and counter, scooping to the liver section.
Now he catches it. Now you're starting to see Rodtang. You can see him at the end of that first round, kind of pounding his chest, firing himself up, shaking his head. That's the Rodtang we're used to seeing.
There is a moment in previous contests we've seen where Rodtang goes from Bruce Banner to the Incredible Hulk. Are we going to see it here in the second round? We will see it later on. Nice, hook to outside leg kick there from Rodtang. Haggerty switches stance. Southpaw now. Front kick off the back leg. Now back to orthodox. Very tight in his guard here, Jonathan Haggerty. A 22-year-old world champion from England. Sticks the front kick into the guts again of Rodtang. Good outside leg kick, harm the thigh there from Haggerty.
Rodtang's starting to evade a lot of these kicks now. He's moving his head a lot better, getting out of the way of these. I think he's starting to figure out the reach there. You can see just how long the leg reach, the advantage that Haggerty has. And Rodtang's starting to figure it out a little bit more. Expect Haggerty to start going to the legs and body a little bit more.
Rodtang has the edge in power, but Haggerty, it looks like, has the edge in speed and precision. Down at elbow, looks for a dump from Haggerty. That was a little late in the blow there after referee Onari went to break them, and Haggerty complaining to Onari there.
Yeah, but it wasn't quite really a break. Like, the referee was there, but he didn't really have his hands in there separating him. So, I don't know, maybe it was the angle that I didn't quite see, but it looked like Onari wasn't really trying to break him.
Front kick there from Haggerty. Once again, folks, make sure you follow ONE Championship across all social media platforms, on Instagram, on Facebook, and on Twitter. A lot of fans watching tonight. Big hello to Mauro Pomali watching in Tuscany, Italy tonight. High kick from Haggerty. Trying to loop the shin around the back of the neck. Outside thigh kick from Rodtang. Now we're seeing Rodtang raise the mercury, raise the temperature, raise the aggressor meter.
This is what Rodtang has to do.
I'll take my feet.
This is what Rodtang has to do. He cannot allow Haggerty to push forward and be this aggressive. He's got to slow Haggerty's aggression down. Cut him off. Start putting heat on him.
Two down, three remaining. A beautiful horizontal elbow there from Rodtang, but was it a little late?
Go!
Strap yourselves in for the ride of a lifetime.
Well, Michael, that's what happened to Sam A. Guyong-Hadao. We saw Jonathan Haggerty get ahead in the first couple rounds, and Sam A. Guyong-Hadao never got a chance to get back into it because Haggerty just kept pouring it on.
And you see Rodtang now. He'll start the showboating. He'll start the theater, and he'll start the heavy sailboat. Hooking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty tries to dump him. Rodtang looks to return the favor. Both men trade knees to the ribs, and referee Onari breaks it.
Go!
That's what Rodtang needs to do. He needs to keep Haggerty on his back foot, not allow Haggerty to go forward and control all those feints.
Rodtang coming forward a lot more already here in this third round of five. That's what he does. That's why they call him the tank. He just comes forward and rolls over you. Rajadon man slipping down. Gets to the ring of the air, there's Rodtang. Haggerty tries to counter with a hook off the ropes, drifts back clockwise, thrusts out the jab. You see Rodtang trying to walk him down now. He wasn't doing that the first two rounds. Is Haggerty going to stand with go toe-to-toe? Has he going to play that game? Is he going to try to let Rodtang's ego open him up here? Rodtang goes to the liver. Haggerty felt that one. Double forearms guard is high. These forearms guards are. Haggerty tags him. And now he'll take time. They're choking it out of the phone booth. Smack bang goes Haggerty. And Rodtang thrusts out the lead leg. Goes to the waist. Haggerty counters body shot. High kick. Haggerty thrusts out the trap. Circles off to his left, but he's going into the power side. Another liver shot, like he's digging for oil. This is a great round for Rodtang. Haggerty evades the leg kick, takes the inside thigh kick, goes high, misses the target. Checks the low kick, jab from Haggerty. Gotta get off the ropes though, gotta get off the ropes though, gotta get off the ropes. And now he does after running it over.
It's a much better round for Rodtang. This is what we'd expect from the Iron Man. To go forward and throw
a downward elbow! And a dump down from Rodtang. Another downward elbow! With some mean intent from Jonathan Haggerty. But we told you Rodtang would wait till the third round and pick up the punch. Indeed, he's done that in true time fashion.
But Haggerty's landing shots too. He's landing a lot clear shots. We're seeing the aggression from Rodtang, and the crowd might be ooh and on. But Haggerty is picking him away, slowly landing jabs, landing kicks.
Jab two combination from the champion on the high kick. Rodtang goes downstairs. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Left hook. Haggerty fires the elbow. Goes down the center corridor. A beautiful catching dump there from Rodtang. It's scoring stuff from Rodtang.
Everybody seems to be impressed by what the Iron Man is doing right here. Look at this big right hand. Boom! Touches the ear.
Go! Jonathan Haggerty versus Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Do you like the counters of Haggerty so far? I like how he's throwing a combination. He steps, then he throws that right kick or that left kick, and he steps back. And that's when Rodtang starts to come forward, and Haggerty's able to hit him or something.
Front kick again from Haggerty, finding range. Outside leg kick from Rodtang. Pressure. A hooking punches and the power up of the forearms blocks. You see Haggerty tried to slice and dice and fillet there with the uppercut elbow. Good front kick. Nice long extension off the lead leg. Jab from Haggerty.
A little bit of deflection right there from Rodtang as that jab came in lightning fast.
Nice tip to the lead thigh from Haggerty. Then skips up inside thigh kick. Threads the jab again. Takes an outside lead kick. Body shots. Oh, the shot's hurt him. The liver shot's hurt the champion.
Haggerty's got to move.
And Rodtang knows it. He's going to go to that liver. He's going to try and blast the right side of the body of the champion. And Haggerty needs to find a way to cut him. Needs to find a way to open him up with the elbows now. And here comes the Iron Man, here comes the tank. Now he's got incredible hope. Now the ticking time bomb has exploded. Rodtang marching him down, eats a jab. Haggerty circles away from the power side. There's a front kick. Haggerty's got to give himself a chance to recover. And Rodtang says, stop dancing, come and engage with me. He's trying to get inside Haggerty's mind. He wants Haggerty to play his game. Wants him to suck it into a brawl. But Haggerty not falling for it. He's not going to take the bait yet. Oh, nice front kick there. A taste of the feet once again for Rodtang. Downward elbow. Hoping for the collarbone. Jack. But he's doing a Beyonce. He's going to the left, to the left. He's going to the right. Go. Stay away from the power side of Rodtang.
He's doing a good job of slowing down. He says, this is for a belt. Come on, let's go toe-to-toe.
And how about this?
into it.
Haggerty calling Rodtang forward, saying, no, you come on, you bring it. I'm not coming to you, you're gonna come to me.
Yeah, that's just mind games though. He's still moving though. He's on his bicycle. Looks at him, points to the ground, says, let's go.
Haggerty playing the mind games. Saying, I made you lose your ground. Come on back into the phone booth.
Oh, it's gonna come down to the fifth and final. With that knockdown. It's very close right now. Look at him coming forward. Boom, with just a wild hooking combination sends the champion crumbling to the mat as Rodtang starts to turn on the heat.
They touch gloves. It could be drawn at the moment. Once again, winning boxer gets 10 points. Losing boxer in the round, in your opinion, gets 9. Usually, if there's a knockdown, it's a 10-8 round.
Yeah, I think that knockdown changed it, though. I think it changed it. Beautiful evasion there from Rodtang.
Rodtang showboats. A little too slick. Roundhouse kick from the top. Haggerty, cheek down the center. Needs the elbows. 2 now. And not allow Rodtang to go to his liver and then sling the hand to the jaw. Those hooking punches of Rodtang are phenomenal. And then generally goes to the legs. One way to slow down the punching of an opponent is to kick their legs. Every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and comes up the body.
Haggerty's scoring with the leg kicks there, but you can see Rodtang catching the kick, sweeping out the leg, putting it down. Now dumps do count as a clean technique.
Tries to push kick. Haggerty. Rodtang may be waiting for the final 60 seconds or so here.
He can't wait though. Haggerty's doing a lot of scoring here with his legs, pushing on the teeth.
Yeah, this
look
is
at that.
Haggerty's round so far, no
That's
doubt
scoring,
about it.
That's scoring, Michael. That's scoring. All these things are scoring.
Rodtang throws two punches, doesn't connect, takes the round kick on the forearm. Haggerty catches that one. There's one to the humerus, but there was nothing funny about it. Haggerty, nice roundhouse kick. Rodtang on the front foot, eats a jab. Body shots, then the hooks to the head. Chance for the knees and elbows on the inside here.
Strong into that clinch, wraps his hand around the head. Throws a little bit of a knee, but chooses to let it go.
1 minute 5 remaining, fifth and final round for the Flyweight Championship of the World. Jab 2 from Jonathan Haggerty. Front kick from Haggerty, it has been superb all night. It is the prime weapon of the champion. Nice stiff right hand. Rodtang apologizing. Or saying, no, maybe Haggerty accidentally slipped a finger in the eye. It happens with these open gloves. Front kick, testing the waters here, Haggerty. And he threaded an overhand elbow to the top of the head, perhaps. Or maybe skipping for a downward elbow to the collarbone.
30 seconds, Michael. This is it right here. Last 30.
Does one of these two men pounce on the other now? Jab 2, a high kick from Jonathan Haggerty.
Nice 2 landing there by Haggerty as he cut through the guard.
This is going to be razor close, folks. This is going to be a razor close decision. Haggerty switches now back to orthodox.
Haggerty can take this round. It might be even, and they have to go to criteria for that.
No draws in one super series. No draws.
And new one Flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Momotaro comes out kicking high. Look out for the rear leg ground kick. There's the first one from Petchdam. If he goes to the body with that round kick, or he goes to the head, Momotaro could be in big trouble. Momotaro's got heavy hands. We know that Petchdam doesn't like getting punched. Let's see what happens if Momotaro can land the leather to the jaw of Petchdam Petchyindee Academy.
Like the distance game that Momotaro is playing, using that left, that right kick as kind of a range finder, just throwing it out there like a jab, just touching Petchdam, seeing what his reactions are.
There's the overhand from Momotaro. Here comes the power. Petchdam with the elbow on the inside.
They tie up now. Petchdam tries to turn him around. A little tango against the wall. And a dump from Momotaro.
Beautiful timing on that sweep right there. Just as Petchdam picked up that leg, Momotaro spun him around, put him on his backside. 41 seconds has passed, but we still got that knockout power coming from both these guys.
But what a confidence booster for Momotaro to have just dumped a three-time Muay Thai world champion. Roundhouse kick from Petchdam. Momotaro backs him up, and a southpaw stance both men.
You can see the swagger coming off of Momotaro, keeping his hands low, jetting in and out, not paying any regard to the power of Petchdam.
Momotaro's confidence is peaking right now. And he dumps him again, throws him to the canvas, and referee Elias Galapsis just warns for the excessive holding.
Can't hold, you gotta only get one step, and then you gotta throw a technique. Can't hold and take multiple steps, but he did kind of throw him flat on his face, though.
This is not the start that Petchdam thought he'd have. The baby shark fakes. There's the rear leg, he goes up high. He'll try and break down the forearms of Momotaro. He'll try and expose Momotaro's ribs, maybe expose the neck, hit that carotid artery.
You gotta keep in mind, Michael, that Petchdam had problems with Elias Inahachi's style, who is kind of similar to this sort of in and out, hands down, quick, fast movement, unorthodox kickboxing style coming out of Momotaro. Petchdam had problems with that, and we're seeing sort of the same thing right now.
That was in kickboxing, however, this is Petchdam's preferred rule set. This is Muay Thai. This is where he's won multiple world titles. It would be considered an upset in the Muay Thai world should Momotaro win tonight. On the world's largest martial arts fantasy game, one fantasy on the one super app, only 19% of fans tipping a win for Momotaro.
Stop!
Referee Galapsis breaks them. But the confidence of Momotaro, the authority he has shown in the opening 3 minutes here.
Look at the way Momotaro is flurrying in. He comes blitzing forward, but when he does that, he's leaving himself exposed.
Sold out inside the Mighty Mall of Asia Arena. Got an empty seat in the house, and they're loving this one. Big uppercut there from Momotaro. Dumps him again. Beautifully done. Muay Thai 101 from the Japanese athlete. That will psychologically deflate Petchdam. Being dumped by Momotaro. Having to pick himself up off the canvas. And it will score well in the judges' eyes for Momotaro. Will Petchdam up the aggressor meter here in the second? Jab two, Momotaro throws a hook. And dumps him again. Momotaro showing the strength and the technique in the clinch.
Beautiful timing from Momotaro inside that clinch. The way that he's angling his legs and he's able to kind of deflect.
He just tried an axe kick. He tried an axe kick on Petchdam. It's audacious. Momotaro putting on a show so far. A roundhouse kick there from Petchdam. Short right hand from Momotaro. Inside the phone booth now. Momotaro shrugs him off and weaves in that rear hand off the left.
Yeah, Momotaro is feeling himself right now in round two. Petchdam needs to change things up, earn that respect from Momotaro. I like the way Momotaro's throwing that lead right kick.
Petchdam needs to pull the trigger on that left leg, but Momotaro's movement has hindered it.
Yeah, that's exactly right. It's that movement, it's that unconventional, almost that kickboxing or karate style that Momotaro is starting to implement right now. It has Petchdam a little bit frustrated, especially inside the clinch. When he does go inside and engage, watch him cut the angles, dump him on his backside.
In 4 ounce gloves here, all of our one super series matches are conducted in 4 ounce gloves from Muay Thai. The larger gloves for kickboxing. Uppercut there from Momotaro. Elbow from Petchdam, looking to crack it against the bridge of the nose.
Stop!
And referee Galapsis breaks them. Under a minute to go, second round of three. We have three judges circle side scoring on a 10-point must system. The winner of the round gets allocated 10 points. The less dominant athlete gets 9 points. Nice knee there from Petchdam. And they are barking instructions for Petchdam from the Petchyindee Academy corner. Thrusting elbow from the baby shark. Momotaro all tied up, and referee Galapsis breaks them.
Yeah, they want to see more action coming from Petchdam, but it's hard to find a rhythm when Momotaro keeps changing. evasion. Nice little left hand landed by Momotaro.
Both men guaranteed a knockout. Petchdam starting to wind that rear leg round kick to the neck now of Momotaro. He did the damage to the body like that against Josh Connor. It was to the neck of Kenny C. Also has a win over a Japanese opponent in Masahide Kudo.
Okay.
Cruising with confidence. Second round, Petchdam up this game.
You think Petchdam got that second round?
I don't want to say, Mitch. It's very close. I think he may have just edged it and maybe one round apiece. It could be 2-0 to Momotaro. Definitely not 2-0 to Petchdam.
Man, Momotaro has the speed advantage. He is lightning fast at closing that distance.
Petchdam needs to get that left leg going. Momotaro switching starts. There's the high left leg from Petchdam. He has knocked out so many opponents to win so many titles over the years. But that's what he doesn't like. He doesn't like getting punched in the face. Petchdam picked in the academy.
And that jab is what's doing it. Setting everything else up. It's distracting Petchdam. It kind of discombobulates him a little bit. But he is throwing that left kick, and it is scoring on the body of Momotaro.
Momotaro, very sidearm stance, almost a karate stance of the Japanese athlete. Catch it, counter, looks for a dump, gets the dump here on Petchdam, and travels down with it. 150 remains, third and final. Momotaro's got to keep the volume, the output high here. Nice knee to the upper right rib cage from Petchdam. Tried to pull the head down for the meet and greet.
I felt those knees inside that clinch landing from Petchdam. He needs more of that inside that clinch, but that left kick scored again onto the body of Momotaro.
That left kick now starting to do the damage Petchdam had hoped for. Momotaro's corner are going to burst a blood vessel. They are screaming so many instructions at him. Again, you see that very sidearm stance.
Hands coming from Momotaro. He needs more of that. He needs to get out of the kicking range of Petchdam and start letting those hands go.
With the sidearm stance of Momotaro, it closes down the target area. It lessens the target area for Petchdam to connect to. The more you square up to Petchdam, the more you open up your entire front body and side for those roundhouse kicks.
Stop! But it does open up that side for his body. If you are standing side on, you can start laying in that kick, and that's exactly what Petchdam is doing. You can just see the welting that is starting to develop on the side of Momotaro because that left kick is starting to find a home.
Momotaro, you see there, he edged you with the jab and immediately got out of kicking range, expecting a counter from Petchdam. This is what Momotaro is doing so well. He is not allowing Petchdam to get into that range where Petchdam can fire off that rear leg round kick that is prime weapon for the time.
Stop!
It's a very smart performance from Momotaro so far. High IQ here from Momotaro. Jumps into range, fires the uppercut, wrenches him, looks for another dump, won't get it. Referee Galapsis breaks them.
That's it, finish.
Yeah, it was those kicks. These body kicks were the story of the third round. Just over and over, just touching up the body of Momotaro. Petchdam finally started to find that rhythm. And once he does, he starts to let it go.
By majority decision from the red corner.
Chavello, Mitch Chilson with you. Red trunks of the champion, Rodtang, Jitmuangnon. As Mitch said, the Iron Man could start slowly. Do a bit of window shopping. See what Gonsalves has to offer. And then open up. Good inside play kick there from Rodtang. Gonsalves could not allow Rodtang to establish rhythm. Outside leaky from Gonsalves.
Salvez has been a long time training and competing in Thailand, so he says he's used to the style which Rodtang brings. But I gotta say, Michael, I don't know how many people are competing exactly like Rodtang do.
Here comes the Brazilian! He tagged it! Rodtang comes straight back! That's what I was talking about earlier! Gonsalves wants to get in your face! And in your face!
kick could have woke up a sleeping beast inside Rodtang.
Underhand right smack bang! Rodtang has tasted the power.
This first round is Gonzalez's opportunity. This is where he needs to jump on Rodtang while he's going nice and slow.
Gonzalez, WPMF World Champion, spins back to center circle, high on the balls of his feet. Rodtang, who defeated Jonathan Haggerty of the UK for the Flyweight World title. Jab overhand right here from Gonzalez and received a poke to the eye.
Yeah. Injury time! Injury time!
Oh, word. What a start, though, from Walter Gonzalez. Shot it in respect to the arena. To that man, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Our athlete
has received
3 minutes.
You can see Rodtang just framed out his hand. It's a defensive strategy to stop an oncoming opponent. And with these open-fingered gloves, it creates some exciting matches, but it just grazed the eye completely inadvertent. Not something Rodtang meant to do. An athlete is allowed up to 3 minutes. That's the duration of a round for medical examination and recovery. If an athlete is unable to continue in the allotted time, an official decision will be given. Now, we only go to a judge's scorecards if we reach past the halfway point, or in this case, we reach that fourth round. But Gonzalez doesn't need that much time. He is ready to get back to action.
Rodtang Jitmuangnon, the son of rubber tree farmers. And his first Muay Thai match as an 8-year-old in a temple fair. After just 2 weeks training, he won the match. Down in Tiongkok, Sawat, southern Thailand. Salvez must have confidence. The left hook there from Rodtang, and he calls Gonzalez for it. Taste of the power from Rodtang Jitmuangnon. The Iron Man still hasn't gotten out of first gear, though. He does be afraid. They clinch up. Huge cut. Tried to put him through the canvas. Walter Gonsalves introducing himself to over 140 countries tonight.
Potentially 2.5 billion people are watching this young man compete. Good movement, and we see Gonzalez. He's managing the distance, moving back. He's going to consistently switch stances.
Lots of confidence on the Brazilian. Bouncing up and down, switching starts. Leg check there from Rodtang. Overhand right just on the bell, and he got the job.
This is how it all got started. This kind of turned Rodtang up a little bit, but look at this beautiful head kick. Look at that, wrapping the shin around the back of the head of Rodtang. Rodtang ate it, just consistently pushed forward. Gonzalez measuring the distance, waiting for him to come in. Look at that beautiful catch to the leg kick, and he threw the right hand. Look at that, Rodtang catches the push kick and then comes back.
As part of the largest martial arts show ever, it's one century. Southpaw stance here on Gonsalves. Second of five. Outside leg kick, Gonsalves. Looping the tag from the Brazilian. Very long arms on him. Could be a huge shot. Gonsalves knocks out one time. As I said, 86% of fans on him. One app fantasy game have tipped a Rodtang win tonight. To mention, most pundits believe Rodtang will get the win. Gonsalves, who is impressive so far, who is pulling the trigger on his strikes. Outside leg at the end, Gonsalves scores for it. Catch and counter. Rodtang closes that down.
Stop!
And they go to each other. Referee collapses, breaks them.
Gonsalves has a lightning fast shot. His follow up shot to set things up.
See Gonsalves begin for the counter off the legs of Rodtang. Clash of legs, clash of shields. Catch and counter again from Gonsalves. Gotta be careful though, Gonsalves. He's not willing to telegraph that catch and counter, or Rodtang will read it, will bait him.
Stop!
All pitched up the ball there from a referee to Lapsus. Rodtang clubs are high. Round kick goes to the right ribs. Gonsalves on the back foot. Good sticky left hand there from Walter. Rodtang edging forward, not throwing the hands though. There's the hook. Gonsalves saw it coming. Double forearms guard against the round kick. And again, blocking the round kick. Counters off it. From Gonsalves, and Rodtang says, come on, get the center circle foul, let's do it in the final, make the call.
Gonsalves can't get sucked into this. Rodtang, look at him, just angry, pounding on his chest, beckoning him forward, trying to get him to come in and exchange in a firestorm with him. But Gonsalves keeping his composure, he's not getting suckered into this. He's moving back, keeping that distance, and he's landing.
Still Gonsalves on the back foot. Will he go into the phone booth?
Stop! Right!
Will he make that call?
Stop!
Rodtang wants it. Switch high kick there from Rodtang.
Stop!
No sweep just after the bell from Walter Gonsalves.
Well, look at this, how he catches. He takes the arm and then comes right back with a combination. Gonsalves is doing a good job not getting baited in.
Coming at him like Gonsalves has. Gonsalves has hit the jab here with a number of clean shots. Not only that, but he's proven elusive too. Lots of movement. Refusing to engage in a brawl with Rodtang. Just got out of the way of the counter. Saw it coming.
Gonsalves found that, Rodtang found that amusing.
Evasion again from Gonsalves. There's the catch and counter from Gonsalves that he's been using for the previous two rounds. Step across elbow, left hook from the Brazilian, drifts off to center circle. Spinning back elbow, Gonsalves. Rodtang trying to walk him down, but he's not finding a standard target. So elbows down from Rodtang on the inside.
This is nice for Gonsalves. This is key. He's got to keep that head moving. I like how he's coming in. And you can see Rodtang overcommits with some of those punches. And that's when he's starting to throw that spinning back elbow.
Stop!
Tries to dump in. Just Gonsalves had a huge dump in the opening round on Rodtang. His dumps will play into the judges. No doubt about that.
Hey! Come on!
Referee Talapsis wants to see a little more engagement from these two. Rodtang. And Gonsalves. Gonsalves goes downstairs from Blair.
Stop! Come on! Come here!
Double
yeah.
Card can come out yeah. Here from referee Delapsis if they're not careful.
Hey. Action!
Rodtang saying he wants Gonsalves to engage, but the onus is also on the champion.
Gonsalves has got to keep moving forward. He can't keep moving back. He can't engage with Rodtang. That is not a smart strategy. He's got to keep scoring, keep throwing the leg kicks, and consistently move. Not staying in front.
Gonsalves got hit with a left hand and said, come on, is that all you've got? Oh, smart! He goes down there! Oh, the jab referee Delapsis from the hook of Rodtang. And Rodtang comes forward again. Roundhouse kick to the ribs. Hat-trick counter there from Gonsalves. Low kick to the back foot. Out of southpaw stance. Body shot. Hook misses for Rodtang. 45 seconds, 4-5 drag.
Gonsalves doing a good job of shutting down the offense of Rodtang, not getting baited into the games. Rodtang's gonna have to cut that circle off.
Roundhouse kick from Rodtang. Gonsalves on the outside. Three judges circle side, scoring a 10-point must system. The little round gets 10 points. Gets 9 points. 10-8 if there's a knockdown usually. No knockdown so far. So too for Rodtang. This crowd oohs and ahs every time Rodtang comes agonizingly close.
And they're out.
Look at this. Gonsalves keeps backing up, but he's landing. Look at that beautiful right hand. But then Rodtang bounces him off the circle wall with a huge right hand.
Also subscribe to the One Championship YouTube channel. An ultimate round here. Rodtang has the experience, 310 bouts to Gonsalves' 70.
Man, razor close three rounds. It'd be very interesting to see how the judges have this scored so far. He's got that constant aggression coming from Rodtang. We're seeing a lot of counter strikes and landing clean techniques from Gonsalves.
Rodtang's last knockout in one set. Oh, that was a nice knockout. Good leg kicks over Subtee. One Warriors of Light back on May 10. 1 minute 36 of the second round that one came in.
It's the second off-balancing punch that Rodtang's thrown. And it's, you know, Gonsalves down, but it's kind of just off-balancing him. He's tripping him. Disrupting his balance. Gonsalves pops back up, so no knockdown yet. Scored by Galopsis. A tie kick.
Rodtang made his one Super Series debut back in September 2018 against Sergio Gilson of the Netherlands. Gilson, a decorated world champion, line fight world champion. Rodtang took care of business without too many hits. The referee is going to really give the stern warning now.
Listen, one more time, yellow card, okay? Action.
Let's jump on to get on Elias Talaxis' bad side. He wants to see more engagement. Uppercut elbow from Gonsalves. Mitch, referee Zalapsis was a big tap again from Gonsalves. Oh, Rodtang claimed it was a throwback. Looked like a good enough dump to me. So too to referee Zalapsis. Referee Zalapsis did say Mitch, a caution could be coming for a yellow card. What would that entail?
That would include a 10% deduction from the purse of each athlete, whoever receives the yellow card.
As forward is Rodtang. I believe, Mitch, I really do, that Rodtang has been frustrated by Gonsalves here. I don't think he knew what he was stepping into, that Gonsalves would bring it to Rodtang as much as the Brazilian has.
And neither did 80% of the fans, too.
86% of fans believing Rodtang will win. Oh, elbow there from Gonsalves. Look at that evasion. He makes Rodtang all over by his own momentum.
See, I don't think referee Galopsis is warning them about, you know, the backward movement of Gonsalves. I think he's warning them about the time that Rodtang is complaining, that pause in the action.
Rodtang's frustrated. No doubt about it in my mind. They spin around against the circle fence again. Throw short knees on the inside.
With very good reason. You see the way he puts everything he has into these shots. Gonsalves slides out of the way.
Exactly, you see the way that Gonsalves evades these big strikes. And just a moment ago, we saw the momentum of Rodtang.
Power that he's coming with, but he just slides right out of the way. Look at that, he catches him with the left hook, but he pops right back up because he was in mid-kick. He was throwing the kick. Now, this is what Rodtang was complaining with. You're not allowed to pick somebody up, but it was a beautiful sweep. But that was...
And what a moment of honor to kick off this championship round. The Southpaw Walter Gonsalves of Brazil giving Rodtang a contest unlike anything we've seen before here in one Super Series. Clinching knees early.
You can see he's looking for that again. Nice little trip there. Good balance shown by Gonsalves. Now, what Rodtang was complaining about is you're not allowed to pick somebody up and then throw them. That's what he was questioning the referee about.
Rodtang edging forward. Fake there from Gonsalves. Two punch combination. Gets out of the range of the counter right hand. Knees from Rodtang. That one to the lower spine. Not permitted. Referee Talaxis breaks them. Rodtang comes forward again. He wants a brawl with Gonsalves. Gonsalves refuses to be suckered in. AKA Brazilian kick.
Up,
which is the
up,
mate, Brazilian.
But
great Brazilian kickboxers and Muay Thai athletes over the years, the likes of Leobe Feitosa, of course, one's own Cosmo Alessandre, Francisco Filio. Rodtang backing up Gonsalves, scooping bolo punch into the midsection. High kick there from Rodtang. It's time for Gonsalves to start landing some scoring shots now.
He's backing up still, he's got good head movement, he's able to get all the power shots, but he's not getting suckered in by the psychological games of Rodtang.
Overhand elbow from Gonsalves, double forearms guard against the round kick. Rodtang continually on the front foot.
Stop! Right.
Rodzak was complaining about the throw off a dump earlier, but how about that from Rodzak? Tying him up in almost a choke there. Left hook from Rodzak. Roundhouse kick. Good counter right hand from Gonsalves. Southpaw stance has gone to orthodox now, Gonsalves, and it's working for him.
And that right hand slips right through the guard. It's scoring heavily from Gonsalves.
Spinning back elbow, and Rodzak got underneath it. Switching stance, Gonsalves just trying to confound Rodtang a little more. 30 seconds remaining. Final round. Rodtang playing to the crowd. But he's going to engage.
He's trying to push forward, but Gonsalves just slides out of the way, ends up on the other side of the circle, evading all counter shots.
A very frustrating contest for Rodtang, Jitmuangnon. Walter Gonsalves' introduction to one Super Series will win him a lot of fans. And there it is. We are going down the judges here in Tokyo.
Look at that. Sets it up with the push kick, switches stances, and then boom, just goes up and then comes right back down. He landed it with the push kick. Look at it. Throws the push kick. He looks like he's going to throw it again when he switches the stance. Look at this, brings it up and then wraps that foot right around the face.
And still one flyweight Muay Thai world champion, Rodtang Jitmuangnon.
Michael Chevalo, Mitch Chilson, Rodtang opens up with a leg kick. High kick there from Haggerty. Checks the low kick. Both men trading legs early. Nice jab from Haggerty. There's the front kick he's renowned for. Rear leg roundhouse kick. Rodtang took a while to open up last time. But until the third, did he really get going?
Let's go.
Will he start more explosively tonight? He said he would. He said he'd go in early against Haggerty. Haggerty told us, I'm playing to Rodtang's ego. Says Rodtang has a massive ego. Rodtang will want to play to the crowd, and that will open him up. Rodtang looks to the inside and outside thighs. Haggerty left roundhouse kick. Rodtang goes for the liver. A taste of the power rolling. In these 4 rounds gloves. There is no room for error. Good right hand there from Haggerty. There's a front kick to the face.
Rodtang like this. He's got to get on that bicycle and start circling now. If his body is damaged, he's got to move. Utilize that push kick, keep that distance. Do not stand in punching range with Iron Man.
Outside leg kick from Rodtang. He's hurt the body of Haggerty. The little shot dropping the man from the UK. They tie up now. Looks for a doctor's Haggerty. Can't affect it. Close the knee to the waist of Rodtang. One star goal from Rodtang, the champion. Good jab there from Haggerty. Rodtang goes back to the liver. He may be telegraphing it. Goes upstairs with a hook up the lead hand. Good right hand down the center corridor. Outside front kick. Another digging little shot like he's digging for oil. It's all about the liver. throws an underhand elbow, puts the jab in the face again, circles on clockwise, checks the low kick. He's moving into Rodtang's power side. High kick again. Feet meet mouth. Final 10 seconds of a 10-8 round here for Rodtang. Throws the left hand. Overhand elbow from Haggerty, trying to lock the ear up. Van Gogh style. Body shot from Rodtang. End of the first round, we go to the towels.
Rodtang goes to the body. Look at that. Hurt him again. You saw it in the first exchange where he went down low with the hook to the body, and then he's kept going after it.
Stand back.
Box. Impacting that vagus nerve. It closes down the whole body. Second round set for five. 10-8 opening round for Rodtang. Front kick there from Haggerty.
Yes!
Very light on the lead foot, switches to southpaw here because the man from the UK. Rodtang edging his way forward, trying to get inside the phone booth. A land that looks shot again. Haggerty back to you. Orthodox stance. Rodtang goes for the liver. What do you do though when Rodtang is hunting your liver? You drop your arm down, you do that, then he goes after your head. Switching stances here, Haggerty.
He's got to stay mobile. He has to keep that push kick coming. Utilize those kicks. Keep him at distance. Do not let him get close like this.
And Rodtang gets close. Haggerty's got to throw the elbow. He's got to hope to open up Rodtang. That was part of the game plan. Let Rodtang come to him. Slice and dice and play with the elbow. Rodtang continually coming forward. So calm, so composed. Chin tuck, looking through his brow. Goes the liver again. He knows that's the sweet spot. It's like a target painted on the right side of the body of Jonathan Haggerty. Up, 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 won the title by defeating the great Sanmai Gangadao in Jakarta. Lost the title to Rodtang in Manila.
Beautiful evasions of the sweep for Rodtang as he got airborne, as Haggerty tried to sweep out that support leg.
Switching stance again, Haggerty from southpaw to Orthodox. Orthodox is his preferred stance. Body shot from Rodtang. Haggerty against the ropes, gets off there, drifts back to center rim. Looks for the inside leg. Want to see the overhand elbows coming to play here from Haggerty. Only a spinning back elbow off the air. Rodtang, he goes for a little shot of his own. There's a front kick to the guts.
Haggerty's got to be careful when Rodtang catches those kicks. You can see how Rodtang's throwing the legs aside, and then he starts digging for those body shots.
Coming in with the elbows again on that occasion, though I feel the left side of the head of Rodtang was exposed. Southpaw stands, back leg kick, gets out of there the right hand counter. Rodtang comes forward, goes to the liver again. I've lost count of how many body shots to the liver Rodtang has thrown inside of two rounds.
And Michael, if Haggerty tries to go in for those elbows, he's going to close that distance and enter Rodtang's punching range.
The round 10 points, the less dominant boxer gets 9 points. Look at this. Is that amazing? To evade the sweep.
Round 3, box.
He is staring down a 10-8 opening round where he got knocked down, and possibly a 10-9 second round for Rodtang. Big jab goes from Haggerty. Rodtang forcing him back against the ropes. Haggerty doesn't want to go there. Down from Rodtang, nicely executed. He needs to get to that deep pitch. Needs those elbows. Booking punches from Rodtang. Haggerty calls him forward. That's usually what Rodtang does to opponents. Is he going to try and open up the ego now of Rodtang? We haven't seen Rodtang slap his face or pound his chest or play to the audience yet. It's been a much more tame Rodtang. It's been a very aggressive Rodtang.
Right. This is where Haggerty's got to be careful. He can't engage
using these types of exchanges with Rodtang, where he gets pushing backwards, because that's how he lost his foot and got knocked down in the fourth round last time. He has to keep his footwork going, utilize those shots. There's that downward elbow that you were calling for, Michael.
Going for the collarbone tracker. There's a little shot from Rodtang. Haggerty having words with Elias Dilopsis.
Time!
The referee.
Injury time!
Maybe
injury time!
Thumb or something in the eye of Haggerty. An injury time being called. Here is the doctor takes a look at the eye of Jonathan Haggerty. Haggerty, I feel, is trying to enter into the mental space of Rodtang here in the third. Maybe leave himself open and make a mistake. There it is, a thumb in the eye off the left hand, accidentally, of course, from Rodtang.
Accident.
He wants to bite Rodtang. Hope that Rodtang will make a mistake. He'll slip up. He'll leave himself exposed. On the outside, Rodtang about to up the aggressive meter, it looks like. Good right hand there, jaw rattler from Haggerty. Another one there from the bridge. Rodtang backs him off, body shot, belly button through the back, level time, down again. Mm.
That's
it. Deafening in here.
Seven.
The second time Haggerty's been dropped with a liver shot, and he's also cut.
He's got to be careful at this point. He's getting sucked into that exchange with Rodtang. He's got to move. Get on that bicycle. Do not play with this dangerous, dangerous game with Rodtang.
Rodtang going for the finish. Backs off Haggerty again. They are two 22-year-olds. And now you see Rodtang's ego coming into play. The beating in the chest, the slapping in the face. That's what Haggerty wanted. That's the Rodtang Haggerty City prepared for.
If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.